Guys, welcome to a new video, and today we are gonna look at Stephen Bodzin's singularity. So I've made a small loop of the project file, and it has that kind of analog kind of sound, and I really dig it, and it's a great sound, and it is a very unique style of writing which he uses, and we're gonna look and explore how he writes and everything, and what kind of sound he creates, how he creates it. So I'll be putting the project file to download in the description, and please like the video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. So I'll be putting out more tutorials like this. So let's go to the project file and check it out. So this is a lead, okay. So let's see what the lead is. So the lead is basically Mini V3, okay. So we're using a small cutoff over here. We're using is a sawtooth wave, saw waves, and this one is set to triangular, and this is a range of 16 and 16 16, a bit low. There's a low attack time, okay, and low aroundish 600-500 delay, 500 ms delay, and there's a low cutoff over here. And basic bass, but the main thing which creates the bass, the unique sound, is the automations that he does in the track. So the three automations which I focused on is the modulate or automation, the second is the cutoff, and the third is the pitch bend. So let's see the pitch bend. The pitch bend is, it goes like this kind of thing. Cutoff is also that it creates a pitch bend, and it creates that unique sound which normally you can't just directly dial in the lead and do it. So that's a very important automation for a track. So the next automation is the cutoff. Cutoffs over here. Cutoff opens up the filter a bit and gives that mids that it needs for the lead. Okay, and the mod wave automation. Modular automation also is very unique, gives that unique kind of sound. So I'm using a simple compressor over here to give it a bit of compression and to give it a big peak. And this is a sidechaining compression, and this is the EQ which I'm cutting out a bit of a low end, because I'm using a bass over here, a sub bass. So let's look at the sub bass. It's a very basic bass, okay. I'm cutting out the low end over here a bit, and it has a compressor which is sidechained to the kick. And the Mini V3 is very basic, it's the almost the initial preset. So then let's hear the bass. It plays one note throughout the track, okay. And this is a low attack time filter, a low cutoff on the filter. So this is a very simple bass that I've made using Mini V3, which plays around the track. Now comes the main important element, the arp, the high arp which plays throughout the track. So these are the notes which he plays, okay, and it has some melodic changes over here. So but it's basically one pattern which keeps on playing throughout the track. So the arp is Mini V3 again, and we're using a square wave again, triangular wave, and a sawtooth wave, a bit of a like a mix and match over there. And some range which is a bit high, and that kind of gives it kind of that high kind of a sound. And I'm also in the higher octaves over here. Yeah, I'm also in the a bit higher octave, not that much actually. So it's set a bit high, and it has a high cutoff at 2. It's at 2. And this is the attack time. The attack time is also very low. There's a decay time for it. And a bit of a reverb I've added to give it that kind of sound. the reverbish kind of sound, because it's a high frequency which we need to put it a bit in the background. So this is a compressor. The compressor is again sidechained to the kick, so that's a very important element to sidechain your kicks every time. You can sidechain your kicks using a LFO tool, or you can use a compressor to sidechain the kick, depends upon you. So LFO sometimes can give a better precise sidechaining, but currently I've used a compressor, your Ableton's compressor. So let's look at the kick. So the kick plays throughout the track. It is a very basic kick, so let's hear it. Has a good amount of low end. So I've cut a bit of a low end because I'm playing with the low end over here. So I've cut off a bit of a low end because otherwise the frequencies just collapse with each other and it doesn't give that kind of good sound. Okay, so it's a very simple kick which I've EQ'd a bit. Next is the percussions. The percussions is a tom. Okay, the tom plays at the start of the track, which you must be heard if you heard that original track. Okay, so this is a very basic tom. The sample is there for downloading in the project file. Okay, next is the closed hi-hat. Let's listen to the closed hi-hat. It plays throughout the track, okay, and I've EQ'd a bit at the high, I've cut off the low end at the mids because I need just the high end of that closed hi-hat. So it plays throughout the track, and that's a very important element for the track. The next thing is the snare. So Stephen Bodnar's style has a kick, has a snare, has a hi-hats. That's his sound, and his automations are what make that analogous kind of sound, and the sound is pretty beautiful. Okay, so let's hear the snare. Plays throughout the track again. So this is how he uses drumming. He starts up with a tom, he uses his closed hi-hat, then he snares, and then he comes to the claps and whatever other elements is there in the track. Just a note, this isn't the full track, this is a part of a track. This is how showing you how he makes the tracks, the main elements of the tracks. There are a lot of arrangement samples and swishes and white noise that he adds in the tracks, and that's for the arrangement part of it. This is the basic project file for the basic of the track. Okay, so but this lets you understand how the track is made and how his production style is. So this is the snare. Okay, so next let's go to the clap. This is a clap which plays three times in a bar. So a bit of a reverb over there, pretty basic. I'm using PML samples over here. You should check out their channel, Production Music Live. They have great samples, they have great plugins. Just go to their channel. I'll put a link in the description. They have great samples, you have to check them out. So next is the clap head, okay? So okay, this is the second clap on the second channel, another channel. So this has that kind of a wet sound. I have again added a reverb over here, and the decay time is pretty high for this. It's around 4-5 seconds, and that kind of gives it that sound. And it doesn't play at every clap, it plays at the clap with the first clap of the first and this channel. So yeah, so this is how the track is, and this is the channels, and this is the track. So that's about it. We'll play it once actually. We'll just play a small section of it. Yeah, so this is the track, and the project file is in for the download in the description. So download it and do tell me how you like the track, what are the errors I've made, any mistake. You can point them out in the comments. And if you like the video, you tell them in the comments. So if you tried this out or something, and so like the video, share the video, subscribe to the channel. So I'll be putting on more tutorials. And tell me in the comments if what kind of style you want to see more. So what other artists you want to see for the upcoming tutorials. So that's about it. Bye.